so many off-road RC cars. Let's go. Hey, how are you doing? This is Frank from Sasquatchy, and recently we got the milestone of 1000 subscribers, so thanks all to you. And this is the 100th video we've been doing, and I thought it would be a nice idea to do a little shop tour and show you what we have over here in this very tiny little space that I call my workshop, hobby room, whatever you want to call it. It's also my YouTube studio. I think you will be surprised how small it is. Really small. But I will go over everything I have here because it's really effective. I have everything around me and just in place. So it's a really nice place to work. So let's get started. See, there is some RC over here. Those are some tires of Traxxas Stampedus and Rustler. This is the Comical Grasshopper. It's going to be a new build. It's for another project. It's by Blood Brothers, and they make excellent deco webs for, and that's going to be a deco web for one of the cars. Some Lexan sheets, excellent for windows. But this is my my little desk, and over here I have more room to do my builds and everything. Now let's start over here at the top. So a couple of bins over here, and this is a project for Scale CoArts. There's a lot of 3D prints in there, and I just need to find time to put it all together, paint it, and add that to a Scale CoArts. My camera stuff is mostly in this one, and these are some parts that also with this one is for this project. It's a 3D printed Defender pickup that you will see on this channel. Then over here we have several radios, 1, 2, 3, 4 FlashGuy GT3C, all hacked from 3 channel to 8 channel. Two of my Traxxas receivers, and over there there are some other ones, a Red Guide one and one for my Element RC. I have a Dremel over here on a stand, so it's easy accessible close to the workspace. Here I have these magnetic handy. This is for your screws. Very easy when you're doing a build to keep everything together. Some extra lights if I need that. Over here are a lot of toys, or a lot of tools, I have to say. So this is not just RC, this is also for every other project I'm gonna do over here. So we close that up. This is usually my to-do list. And then we go over here. Well, of course you recognize all this. This is always very handy. I have enough over here. Then we start to get into the RC tools. I have some over here. This is a dynamite set that I well, I tend to use mostly on the trails these days. I did a review on this, so there is a video on this on my channel. And over here more tools, some cheap ones, some cheap screwdrivers for the real small sizes. My Tamiya. Tamiya set. And this is my almost full set of MIP. metric drivers. I'm just short of a couple of them. Designed this myself, it's 3D printed. I'm using the DeWalt driver. This is a really nice power driver. Basically it just operates by holding the button, then turning your wrist. Really fantastic. And over here we get into my Tamiya paints. Above here are some glue things. A couple of my Tamiya Wild Rally drivers. Then several paints over here. Dremel tools, Plasti-Dip, some paint killer for Lexan bodies, some Tamiya paint pens, or how you call them, and some other ones by Molito, brushes, Lexan scissors, more tools, things to clean the cars, shock oil, glues, and other bits and bobs from a coating. I use that a lot to waterproof stuff. Then over here we have my solder station, more bits and bobs, and several paint cans. It's also always handy to have that in stock. All the cars, I'll get to those in just a minute. First, let's go over here. Oh no, before I forget. More storage over here. Someone wants to join me. I'll have a second seat. Okay, let's go over here. More tools over here. These are two new kits that I need to build, and some other new stuff that came in. A vise, always handy. Then over here I have a lot of storage. These are mostly screws. I'm trying to build up a collection, so I'll always have every size in stock. And every possible one, like the socket heads and the button heads and flange heads. These are mostly the RVS and steel, all sorts of nuts. They're not all, I don't have them all. I have to buy more to get everything. These are more the electronics and light department. And I have more over there, but I don't have a room yet to hang it on the wall. So there are more things in there, like XT90 connectors and more electronic stuff, servo horns, and that's etc. These are from IKEA, and they are called the Helmer. And usually they have small little wheels under them. I left them out and I used them on the wall. I like to be organized. So we have heat shrink. Now, these are quite handy as a drawer. Actually store a lot. Here I keep my tools, glue, grease, tape, everything that's not in front of my desk. Much every off-road car I have has its own dual. So this is 3D Sets Landy. That's this build over here. That's gonna be Landy Defender pickup. completely 3D printed. SCX 10-2, so that's this car over here. And we start looking at the cars. So as I said, that's a 3D printed car. It's so oncoming project. I will do videos on it somewhere in the next month. Probably when it's done, I'm videoing the entire series. This is the current build series of the Free Racing X-Wheel Koala X with a killer body per year body. This is a long ongoing MST CFX Pajero project. Then there's my Enduro Sandero, the Element RC. Some other stuff over there. My Traxxas Stampede. This used to be a Traxxas Gravedigger, but I changed it to a Stampede style. Don't use it a lot, but it's ready when I want. My weight, one of my oldest builds, with Wild Willy and Wild Wanda in there. The heads turn, you can see that in several videos. The Red Cat Gen 8, I just have taken it all apart, rebuilt it, and I just have to do the interior. Has to go back in the body. SCX 10-2 Jeep Cherokee, same thing as the Red Cat, just got it apart completely and rebuilt it, shimmed it, everything, so it's like new again. Over here we're getting more into projects that need upgrades and rebuilds, so this has been, and this one has been heavily used. And they're currently waiting to get some maintenance and cleaning and some upgrades. This one will have a new body that will also be in a future video. Some parts over here that I intend to use. One of these. Element Enduro, I have a building skid and I have the gatekeeper, so I have a lot to build. Over here I have the bed safes, and this is where I keep all my my lipos. I have several of them, and I just received a new charger, but it's an but I have to find some space for it. So this is the one of the old ones. I sold in another one. So let's go over here. I have a bit more room over here. Normally this is where you will find my racing car. If you never saw it, that's the one. Not really active anymore, but I used to waste it on the circuits. More tools. Oh, I didn't show you guys my air compressor. That's over here. I can connect it to here and then get this wherever I want. So more tools over here, but this is more for the one-on-one car. Shop heater. This is, I have to find space for this. These are mostly the empty boxes. New stuff coming in. So this is more RC stuff. A bit more over here. Also IKEA storage. So my bags when I travel with the RCs. What else have here? Well, this is basically where store all kinds of stuff. And the rest is mostly for one-on-one cards. So as I said, we will go and have a look further in the house. There are a couple of more cards spread it over the house. And I have a lot of several, mostly Tamiya cars, in a really small garage. So, another workshop. Let's have a look there. So over here we have the one of the Traxxas. It was a Sun Eva Digger, but it's now more Stampede Bigfoot. And this is the two-wheel drive. Well, let's call it the Traxxas Stampede of my youngest son. And this is another son of mine. This is his, well, it used to be the Traxxas two-wheel drive Stampede Gravedigger, but we have now a Ford Raptor body on it. In one of my first videos, I showed you this Traxxas Rustler and the drone over there, and how you can make art piece out of it. So this is in the room of my my oldest son. So this shot might look a bit familiar, because this used to be the background of my my little YouTube studio, and the desk is still over here. It used to be like so. It's, one of two of my Tamiya Honda City Turbo cars. I have a video on that, and the other one that is over here. This is what I'm about to show you now, is something I've been building in the last couple of months. Haven't shown this on my channel yet, but I will do that in the future. And as you can see, it is a skill garage, a sort of workshop, I guess. So over here, this is basically where my RC journey in my life started with, and we started it. So I don't have the original one anymore. It's the Tamiya Super Champ, but it was 14 years old, 1983, and that was the car that got me into RC. I later did some, had a Serpent, and had another Tamiya car, long time out of the hobby. And this one, the Traxxas cars I just showed you for my sons, these Tamiya Wild Willys, and this one, they all got me back into the hobby since 2013. As far as the scale garage, it's MDF. Lots of 3D print stuff. So the floor is 3D printed. The stairs, this is all 3D printed. Lexan over here, this is 3D printed. These windows are 3D printed. This is all 3D printed. All the stone walls you see. What else? Most of this is 3D printed. Basically a lot. I don't know if you can see the store over there. That's 3D printed. All that stuff is 3D printed. Stairs over here. Again, the windows. And for the roof, I made this out of wood. And all these things, these are all 3D printed. See the detail on that? Yeah, I will go into more detail in other videos with that. So This is my second workshop. Bit busy at the moment. And my crew is having a lot of work to do. So let's go back to the workshop downstairs. So we are back in my RC workshop, as you can see. And I hope I gave you enough ideas for your own RC workshop. Because you don't need a very big space just to have an area where you can have some of your greatest builds. All you need is a great desk and some storage. And that all doesn't need to cost all that much. So like for instance, the IKEA cabinets that I showed you early in the video, they are around $30 or something like that. I even got them secondhand and much, much cheaper. Or if you want storage for your paint cans, just pipe glued together, and you have some great storage. So it's just all possible for a couple of dollars. Better to spend your money into really good tools like the MIP tools I showed you. So that all said, if you liked the video, give us a like, subscribe if you didn't already, and if you have seen like say the RC cars or any other details I showed you in this video that you want me to show you more, like say one of the cars for a on the bench video, just let me know down in the comments. And for now, I say thank you and until the next video.